Hello and welcome back to One Trainer vs. the World Season 5, when we last left our protagonist, she had defeated the first gym and uncovered the staggering truth that Team Plasma are not good guys. Now she is ready to do some level grinding. And here we see the best way to level grind in the game. Running around back and forth until an Audino shows up. Ugh. Okay, that did absolutely nothing. Okay, that also did absolutely nothing. Tail whip. And look how much more experience that gained me than anything else I've been fighting thus far. Defense curl. Yeah. Like, damn! And again, as I was saying earlier, this game scales experience depending on how big the level difference is between you and your opponent. So, that Audino was several levels below me, meaning if it had been stronger, I would have gotten even more experience from it, and yeah. That was a reduced amount of experience from the baseline, and yet it still got me enough to level up 2 levels, which is amazing. And there we just saw the downside to training against Audinos. They are actually surprisingly tough. What, are you still going to stop me? Alright. I have to go and get some stuff that doesn't even matter because the Wi-Fi network for the DS has been shut down. And anyway, I'm playing it on an emulator, so the Wi-Fi network wouldn't work anyway.
Thanks to you, I got some Dream Mist. Now I can collect save files of various trainers. Thank you very much. As a token of my appreciation, I will give you this Sea Gear to use. The Sea Gear is a device related to communications, such as infrared connection or Nintendo Wi-Fi connection.
Well, I suppose it also allows me to search for nearby trainers, which would still work if I was playing this on an actual DS. But see, I'm not playing this on an actual DS. And how many people actually play Black and White these days, anyway? Blah blah blah. Silence. I want to go and catch some more Pokemon. Oh, battle. Can I avoid it? I don't think I can.
We're going to combine our strength and do our best, so please watch! 1 plus 1 is 2, right?
No! 1 plus 1 is 0! For some reason! I think I just spotted a minor graphical glitch. That is terrible! I thought this game was completely free of minor graphical glitches! That battle was not hard, but it was easy instead. Still, because I once again think I'm going to have to face Charon in a minute, I should heal up before that. Because that dude can be a bit of a douche. Granted, less so now than otherwise, because he doesn't have a, Tepig, because I have the Tepig instead. Yep. Seriously, dude, I just want to catch another Pokemon! And I fought you just, like, right before the gym as well! Why do you have to fight me all the time? Well, this is a perfect matchup. And if I'm not mistaken, all he actually has now is his starter and the elemental monkey, so I should be able to deal with him quite alright. Now hit ever so slightly. You didn't hit ever so slightly harder. How dare you not hit ever so slightly harder, Wukong? Ah well, he's going to resist that, so whatever. Huh, he does not have an elemental monkey. So that completely screws up what I thought was going to happen. Ah well. I'll just send out surprisingly my strongest team member at the moment. Even though her previously surprisingly effective tackle has been replaced with a somewhat worse cut. And let me guess, you're going to hit 5 times, aren't you? You did not hit 5 times. And just a reminder, Tomoko's accuracy can't be lowered, so that was just her hitting that 5% chance of missing. Why does that exist? Why do you keep beating me? We have the same number of gym badges, we should be equals in strength. No, because as I have said a few times before, I am the champion of 4 regions. Excuse me, did something happen just now? I wasn't paying attention, I was too busy lecturing you.
Hey, where were those people headed?
That way, but why are you running now?
Oh, seriously, they run so fast! Miss, my Pokemon? It'll be okay, don't cry!
Bianca, really, why were you running?
You have to hear this! Those people stole this girl's Pokemon!
You should have spoken up sooner! Vega, we're going to get that Pokemon back. Bianca, please stay by the girl's side.
Yeah, interesting. But I need to heal up and then I need to catch a thing and then I need to train a thing! Which is more important than that girl's stupid Pokemon. And there is a thing there. But first, there is a thing that I... Nope! Well, that's a useful thing. Unlike the thing that I just encountered. Okay. That's fine. Although, that is the female version, which if I don't remember it wrong, looks decidedly less cool than the male version. Gotta check again. What would do less damage here? Yeah, I think I get... Oh, that was not what I was trying to do! Damn it! How dare I press the wrong buttons! Pressing the wrong buttons is pure evil! Oh wait, that is actually really bad! Okay, not that bad. But of course, because I am strong and this thing is not strong! Couldn't you use Growl or something instead? Well, it's a good thing Hogan isn't evolved yet, or else a Gust would have done super effective damage on him too. Actually, I am ever so slightly worried about potentially murdering this thing, so I'm just going to immediately throw a ball at it. Okay, I think I will have to attack it one more time. Now don't score a critical hit, Hogan! You did not score a critical hit, Hogan! That is very nice! Of course, this thing appears to be pitifully weak! But still, I could use a flying type, so yeah. And now I have a flying type, so yeah. Once again, hitting a random button landed me on the V, so her name is Vanessa. Now, did I actually take any serious damage in that battle? I did not take particularly serious damage in that battle. Now then, to continue ignoring those Team Plasma grunts and instead just try to level up. Maybe the Dream Yard would be a better place to do that because there would be less grass for me to wade through before I get to the Odinos and such. Alright, I am now stronger! I now have an entire team of level 15s! And in the process of getting an entire team of level 15s, Hogan also now has a flame move that he can use with much more efficiency! So now Tackle is no longer his best move! Which is nice! They ran inside here. Vega, your Pokemon's HP is fine and you're ready to go, right? Then let's go. Well, of course it is. I healed right before coming here. Vega, this bothersome bunch doesn't really listen to reason. That child cannot use a Pokemon to its full potential. Doesn't that make the Pokemon sad? It's the same way for all your Pokemon, so hand them over to us now. Better yet, we'll just take them! Yeah, I'm sure you will, with your Patrats and Purloins. However shall I possibly resist you? You are clearly too much for me! Does my sarcasm come through quite clearly enough? Ah, bugger. The move that Tomoko briefly had, but I got rid of it, because really it's probably not going to help me in any real situation. Unless the opponent is using a two-turn move. That's pretty much the only situation I can think of where Detect will actually be useful to me. Like, any time when I want to avoid damage, I feel like I'd be better served just healing up myself. And if I can't take a single hit from the opponent, then there is really no reason for me to even have that particular Pokemon in.
What? How could we lose when we have Right on our side? Not bad, Vega. Okay, go return the Pokemon to that girl.
You don't need to return it!
How troublesome. Not only do you fail to understand, you actually got in our way to boot. There's two of you and two of us. We'll show you our combined power and teach you that we are right. So, there were more of them. Still, why are Pokemon robbers acting so self-righteous? Vega, we've been friends our whole lives.
We've been friends for less than a year. And honestly, I don't even like you that much.
We've got each other's back when it counts. Let's show them how it's done.
Seriously? So exaggerated. Our whole lives, seriously. That is not even true, you stupid person! Ah, Air Cutter hits both of them? I honestly did not know that was the case. And Tail Whip also hits both of them, so that is also nice. Not that Tail Whip actually helps me, being that I'm currently using a special move, but you know. Now, I can definitely take out one of those things with a quick attack. I could probably also take out the other with a quick attack, maybe, but I'm not sure, so... That was also not a hard battle, but an easy battle instead.
It In order to liberate Pokemon from foolish people, we will take their Pokemon. Whatever, what a waste of time. Come on, what reason could possibly justify stealing Pokemon from people? Pokemon trainers like you are making Pokemon suffer! What do you mean trainers are making Pokemon suffer? I don't get that at all. We'll give you back the Pokemon, but be aware of how this Pokemon suffers from being used by people. Someday, open your eyes to your own complicity. Trainers bring out their Pokemon strength. Pokemon believe in their trainers and respond to that. I don't understand what about that makes Pokemon suffer. Okay, Vega, I'll return the Pokemon.
Meanwhile, I shall stay in this cave and try to catch a thing in this cave. There might be rock types here, so going to lead with Wukong. Okay, then Wukong was actually a bad idea. Yeah, switching over to Hogan. He is not a fighting type yet, so he will not take super effective damage from this thing. Also, it is not, how do you say it, strong. Hopefully it will at least be, how do you say it, strong enough to survive one tackle though. It should survive another, provided I don't get a very badly timed critical hit. I did not get a very badly timed critical hit. Oh, it has confusion. This thing could be of use to me. Now, it's not very creative, but it kind of looks like it's made of cotton or something. At least it reminds me of cotton candy with wings. So I am going to name it Cotton Bat.
Vega, thank you so much. The two of you got her Pokemon back. I'm lucky to have friends like you two. Thank you, miss. Please take this as a thank you present. Oh, those are heal balls! They completely heal the captured Pokemon on the spot! How sweet of you! I'm going to see this girl on her way, so see you later, Vega! Bye-bye!
Now, down here, is this a new area? I don't think it's a new area. How disappointing!
Vega, stop! That dark tall grass over there. Every now and again, two Pokemon will pop out at the same time. In other words, you have to be careful in the darker grass. I'm heading on to Nacrean City.
Yeah, well, I don't see much of a reason to even approach the darker grass. Because there will never be any Audinos in it! We have reached Nacrean City. You're not gonna want to fight me again, are you? Apparently not.
If you go straight from here, there's a Pokemon Center. Clearly, you wouldn't have been able to figure this out on your own. And use this if you want.
Do you take me for a fool, Charon? For I am not a fool, you see! Well, right ahead of here, there should be another area. And in that other area, there should be some potentially very useful things for me to catch.
But it looks like I'm going to have to fight someone first.
You look like someone who uses fighting types.
Cotton Bat is up front, so I can deal with fighting types.
Apparently you were not someone who wanted to fight me. But you are, though, aren't you? No. So that's a thing. Nope. Nope. Yes! You know, I was honestly afraid that I was going to get nothing but piddles, and then this entire area would just be a waste. But that didn't happen. So, nice. Let's see now. Do I have anything that this thing resists? Well, I suppose I have Hogan, but Hogan's kind of strong, so I'm not sure if I want to use him specifically. Well, Cotton Bat's special attack is better than his physical attack. I think a single assurance will be okay. Probably. Yeah, that is indeed quite okay. That noise, wasn't that the same noise that Sing made in Generation 1? I do think it is. Well, I'll just try and throw a ball now. Now, this thing is water ground, or at least it will be. So that basically makes it the Mudkip of this generation. But I already had both Orson and Wells, so just to continue the whole Orson Wells thing that sort of just popped up completely randomly, her name is Paola, who was married to Orson Wells at one point. Shut up, it makes sense, okay?
I actually just lied. I told her that my starter was Oshawott, when in fact it was Tepig. Because you see, for a certain future cause, I really want a Mystic Water.
And some more level grinding later, I suppose I am ready for my next challenge, which at the moment is not the gym. Also, so you know how the one thing that's died in my team so far is a Lillipup? The other day I was just, well, yesterday, I was watching Mystic Umbreon's video on like the best team for Unova, and annoyingly, Lillipup's evolution was on that team, so clearly that might have been a greater loss than I thought.
I want to see things that no one else can see. The ideals of Pokémon inside Pokéballs. The truths of how trainers should be. A future where Pokémon have become perfect. Do you feel the same? That's so. I think my friend and I should test you to see if you can see this future too.
So, as I was saying, next challenge, not the gym! Right. I mean, Cotton Bat can probably deal with this thing, I suppose. Heart Stamp. Right, another two hits of that should take it out. And it doesn't actually outspeed me, so... Ah, I didn't even remember that Heart Stamp had a flinch chance. That is very nice. Now, I wonder if this thing might have a dark move of some kind, so switching out to Wukong! Well, that is not a dark move, but it's still something that would have been kind of disadvantageous for Cotton Bat, so... I think I made the right choice! Now hit through it, Wukong! Thank you, Wukong! Ugh. And of course, it's not part ground type yet, So at the moment this doesn't have a quadruple weakness to grass. I wish it had a quadruple weakness to grass, however. Because if it had a quadruple weakness to grass, that would have been awesome. Actually, I guess Cotton Bat can probably fight this thing fine. Though before that, I think I shall heal him. It's mostly just I want Cotton Bat to be out for the next thing that he is going to send in, so yeah. If he can fight this Timpole, then he should fight this Timpole. Oh, that's troublesome. But not that troublesome. Now, heart stamp. Oh, bugger. If this doesn't kill, I might be in serious trouble. Okay, the next one will kill, so I'm not in serious trouble. See the future yet. The world is still to be determined. Right now, my friends aren't strong enough to save all Pokemon. Maybe I can't solve the equation that will change the world. So I need power. Power enough to make anyone agree with me. Now I know what power I need. Zekrom, the legendary Pokemon that, along with the hero, created the Unova region. It's my turn to become that hero, and you and I will be friends. Well, clearly that guy is not going to become important in any way later. Vega has made it to Nacrian City, gathered a full party of six, and is now almost ready to take on the next gym. How will the gym battle go? Find out next time.